How many souls have been memorialized with those words in the 30-some years we have been here? And how many millions of words of Torah have been spoken in the sanctuary? And so it is with a bit of nostalgia, with a tear or two, that many of us leave the sanctuary. But history reminds us that there have been many, many, many other times in the history of the Jewish people when arks were opened and Torahs were taken out because of pogroms, because of persecutions, and Jews risked their lives to save the Torah, and that's why they went to their synagogues. And many, many other communities were decimated of their Jewish populations through attrition, through persecution, through apathy, through indifference. And therefore, synagogues were left empty. Our story is happily a different story. We are moving on to a greater and to a grander home, to a sanctuary, to a synagogue that will hopefully touch the lives of many, many more thousands of Jewish young people. So we are entitled to our nostalgia, but what we deserve is a simcha greater than any tear that should be shed today. We call upon David Fefferman at this time. Our program begins.
Cantor Schwartz. If everybody will please rise, because we are going to open up the ark. David Kahn, our guardian, the Holocaust Torah, Marsha Weingarten, Phoebe Frank, Holocaust Torah number 2,
we're following a star, sharing all the danger,
Where's the other Holocaust Torah?
Here. Right here.
No, I want it right over here.
Take it from the side, Joe. Joe, go ahead up. We can lay it in without it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. get you down. Say a little bit of a prayer.
Thank you. have our choir come out and let's have some real sound.